is how we're gonna play a baby when baby's born. Hello everybody, it's Bob. So today I have to film quick because I'm filming kind of late today. So I'm scared the sun's gonna go down. I am on my 15th week of pregnancy. So not long till we can find out the sex of the baby. Let's look at the progress of little Peanut. Another thing is, some people are like, are you really gonna be calling your child Peanut? Please don't, Bubs. You realize that your baby is not a pet, right? And I'm like, no, I'm not gonna call my child Peanut. I'm not that cruel. It's just a nickname that when a baby is born, we'll give them a name, so don't worry, guys. Currently, Peanut is 4 inches long from head to rump, so around this big. And right now, his or her bones are strengthening and getting harder, so pretty soon I'll be feeling the little kicks. Some fine hairs, also known as lanugo, are being developed all over your baby's face and body. Oh, so right now I have a hairy baby right now, but this will eventually shed before birth. I believe the little hairs is to keep the baby warm before it fattens up. It says inside the belly, your baby is probably sucking his or her thumb, swallowing, yawning, and tiny eyelashes are present. Your baby may also be smiling. You guys may have noticed that my hair is darker now, and I know some of you guys are a little weary about, you know, pregnant women getting the hair dye. I am too, and I asked a lot of questions, you know, I got a lot of advice from doctors. The feedback that I got back is the amount that is absorbed by hair dye is so little that it's not enough to harm your baby. And most of the concern is actually more of the pregnant lady breathing in the fumes. But either way, the dye that I use is actually completely free of ammonia. Also, it's got no fumes, no scent to it, so I don't get to breathe that in. Of course, it's not as strong, so you can still see like little roots here, but it doesn't matter. On the topic of hair, I really think my hair is thicker than ever, and my nails are so strong. Usually they are so brittle, and if there's no nail polish in my nails, they will break. But as you can see, I have no polish in my nails at all, and they are so long. And let's talk about weight-wise, I finally gained weight. Before, remember I told you guys I was around 43 kilograms, and I told you guys that in my first trimester, I did not gain any weight at all. Now in my second trimester, I have gained 2 kilograms, so 1 kilogram each week. On another note, remember last time I was telling you guys that like constipation is such a pain in the butt, literally. It's gone a lot better. I'm not sure what it is. I think it's because diet-wise, I kind of stopped eating so much junk food. Because remember last time I was telling you guys I was craving chicken burgers, I was craving mashed potatoes and, you know, bread, all this stuff that made me feel really bloated. Well, this time I kind of just told myself, like, just because I crave something doesn't mean I should have it. So I kind of tried to not lean in so much to my cravings and just eat a little healthier. I'm having such a hard time looking for maternity clothes because I'm very petite. I know I could just go ahead and buy, like, you know, normal clothes in bigger sizes, but you know, when it comes to bottoms, that's just hard because you kind of need something that caters, you know, more for your, you know, your pregnant belly. But either way, I'm still very thankful for my maternity leggings and my tights. The first time I wore my maternity leggings, I was like, this doesn't feel right. It doesn't even feel like it's doing much for my belly. And I was like really biting my butt, and I was like, oh, I wore it the other way around. Things I have been loving include chicken celery sandwich. I also love the Starbucks passion fruit smoothie, so anything that's got ice in it and it's kind of like tangy and sweet and has a little bit of sourness to it, I like drinking stuff like that. I really love drinking banana milk. I still love mangoes, oranges, just any fruit that's got a lot of juice in it and fruit that's been in the refrigerator so it's nice and chilled. Still cannot stand the taste and smell of broccoli. Yesterday Tim had broccoli soup and I was like, don't kiss me! I can just smell, it's just that strong. My sense of smell is getting stronger. It's starting to get a little uncomfortable for me to sleep, so I don't really know what it's going to be like in a few months time when the belly gets bigger. It's not the belly that makes me feel uncomfortable, it's just I know that now is a time for me not to sleep on my back, so sleeping on my side has just been a bit uncomfortable. I feel like my shoulders get crushed and my back hurts. I'm still getting crazy dreams. Last night I dreamt that Tim and I, we already had a child, okay, and it was a boy, but for whatever reason, we split up, okay, and I started dating this other guy, okay, and I didn't really like him, but the guy really liked me, but obviously Tim and I still loved each other. Tim and I got back together, and I told the guy, and I said, sorry, I still loved him, and I got really angry, and he threatened to burn my house. I'm like, sorry, we're a family. It's such a dramatic dream. Like, I think I woke up like nearly in tears, but I was just so happy just waking up and just realizing it's just a dream. Are we having a boy? Now, on the topic of names, Tim and I, we have kind of decided our baby names like maybe two, three years ago. There's a boy name that we really like, but I can't tell you guys yet, so I'm so sorry. And there's a girl name that we kind of like as well, and we have friends and family who are desperately trying to name our child. Tim's surname is Ng, so my brother Ricky was like, you should call your child Ball. So he'd be like, Balling, you know, because he's balling. And I was like, psh, Balling. And then of course you guys know Leon. Leon's like, call your child Zeus. I'm getting like a bunch of crazy names, but yes, nice to see the family getting involved and being helpful. My sisters have also grown a full cup size as well, because all my old bras don't fit anymore. Now, it really feels like it's just the nippler area that gets itchy. One time, like Tim and I were watching TV and we were just in bed and I had the covers over me, but it was so itchy that I was kind of like scratching away, and he was like, what are you doing? Like, do you need some help? I started to get really bad migraines for a few days. I would be able to feel my temple right here just pulsing, like pulsing, pulsing, pulsing. And it would get so bad that I would just have to like sleep. The gas has started to come back again. It was actually yesterday I was in my car and my tummy was so sore, and I thought I needed to go home and do the number two. But turns out I just needed to do one fart. And Tim was like, whoa! I've been blaming all of the farts on this baby. And from the smell of it, I'm like, it's definitely your child, Tim. Nothing left to do but to show you guys my belly now. So here is little Peanut. Just really popped, really, from second trimester. I don't know how it's gonna... how big it's going to be by then. You know, some of you guys think Peanut's going to be big, but it could just be I have a lot of amniotic fluid. We don't know yet. So. My family are kind of surprised how big the bump is. I'm showing more than they anticipated, so they're like, you're going to look like a penguin when it gets even bigger. I'm just going to be waddling around. Let's do a daddy interview.
Let's do a shave first.
No, they'll understand because they know you just woke up. We know you don't mind whether you have a girl or boy, but say you had the choice to choose one. Would you choose boy or girl?
Neither.
No, you can't answer that. You have to.
Boy.
And why? I knew it! I knew it all along!
It takes all the pressure off like any other children you have in the future.
But I thought like when you dreamt, we already had three kids and you actually preferred the girl.
But the girl was the middle one. That was a boy, girl, boy.
Yeah, and why did you prefer the girl?
I don't know, it's like chubby. Why did I prefer chubby? She's a girl.
Don't tell him with Donald there. What do you like the most about your newly pregnant wife?
I think your bub's pretty cute.
What would you do if Chubby gets really upset about our baby?
She won't get really upset.
Isn't that right, Chubby?
Just look at her. She's not gonna get upset.
Do you think your wife is beautiful?
Of course.